it feels like somebody's like squeezing your heart. That's how I felt. It's very gut-wrenching. Just be prepared for lots of emotions. The idea of shooting this film came about in the beginning of 2018. We were all just kind of taking a leap of faith. We were all pretty, what's the word? Skeptical, I think is the word. I just didn't ever think it was gonna happen. I was like, oh yeah, they're gonna film me, but they're not gonna make a movie, you know? They're just gonna film a bunch of shit, and then we're never gonna actually make a doc, never gonna actually like put it out there in the world. We're never gonna see it, but they did, and they made a good one. Really f***ing emotional. Whoa, oh my God, let me start over. When we first watched it, we were in my living room. I knew there was some stuff in there that I was gonna be mortified by.
Yeah.
Shit happened, so. But I cried out of joy for a lot of it because I guess I didn't really put together the fact that it's gonna be about my life and how many things I didn't know anyone was paying attention to. I never would have thought that anyone would be able to capture exactly what was going on in such a beautiful, like, intimate way. When we were halfway done with the movie, we just paused it and we called my mom and dad at home, and we just were like, all of us, we were just like, we love you, you're such good parents. It was, I mean, I know they're amazing parents, it was just so beautiful to see it. I didn't get to really appreciate how amazing they are and always have been. So I think that's the perspective that changed a little for me. We see things for how we see them. And Phineas, my brother, was talking about how it was really interesting for him to watch the movie because he was seeing me in a different perspective than he's even seen before.
Oh my God.
Shut up. He was telling me that there was just certain things that are in the doc that he was like, that's not ever something I've thought about, you know, with you, but it's you. You know, they were filming for so long that we got so used to the cameras that I don't remember when a camera was or wasn't there. I don't like close up in front of like a camera, which is like a blessing and a curse, I think. There's certain things in the doc that I never planned on sharing with the world. There's a lot of stuff that was very traumatic for me that is in the doc that I had to relive watching, and it's kind of horrible to think about millions of people having access to it, but it's good. I don't need a Sandy. Duh. I think it's cool for people to see another side that they didn't know was there the entire time. So I have to just hide that and not just like, I don't know. I'm nervous, very nervous. Scared, I'm very scared.
You should be excited.
Oh God. I'm very excited for the fans to see this doc. I've been like jumping up and down about it. I'm interested to see how people react to certain things in this movie that nobody knew were going on. You know, barely my family even knew. And know that the fans, you guys, you're the only reason I'm like still right here. So thank you. And I love you. And I am so excited for this journey. And I'm excited to be with you through it all. You gotta watch this movie on a big screen and turn all the lights off, get some blankets, light a candle. You gotta have somebody with you to like squeeze, cause so many moments, like you, yeah, get somebody to squeeze, get some fuzzy blankets, probably wear pajamas, that's what we did. Candle, lights off, big TV.